Hi everybody, I hope you guys are doing great. Today is Erev Tisha B'Av, so we're going to continue obviously with some of the halachot of Tisha B'Av. Number one halacha that we did not mention yet is the ne'ilat sandal, which means we're not allowed to wear leather shoes on the day of Tisha B'Av. It represents luxury and pleasure, and it's not appropriate, just like avelim. Mourners. This is what applies, by the way, all days, not just half a day. So by mincha, we are still not allowed to have leather shoes. If you have shoes that look like leather, it's okay, because there is no such thing as marit ayin. So at the end of the day, if they are not made of leather or suede, that's not a problem. Even if a person has to have a meeting for some reason among non-Jews and he feels very uncomfortable to wear non-leather shoes, at that meeting, the Bet Yosef is very strict and says that there is no exception and he may not wear leather shoes. The only exception that we have is for someone who travels by foot, and it would be very, very uncomfortable to have non-leather shoes, to have something that is of a low quality like they used to have back then, wooden shoes, etc. So the halakha does allow that person to wear leather shoes, but that does not include the person who's traveling by airplane or train, car, subway, etc., because this is definitely not requiring effort in terms of walking all the time. The other halacha that we should mention is tashmish hamita, which means there is no intimacy allowed on Tisha B'Av. Husband and wife should be sleeping in separate beds. Physical contact, however, is okay, so there could be physical contact between husband and wife, and even Homer the Harchakot, okay, so all the other restrictions that are technically allowed on the day of Tisha B'Av. Let me just also talk about the minhag that we have regarding the Talit and Tefilin. So you should know that minhag Yerushalayim is today, and it's by the way most communities in Eretz Israel following Chacham Ovadia, is to put both the Talit and Tefilin for Shacharit and for Mincha. Our minhag, on the other hand, is not like that. As the Pasuk says, Betzah imrato, we do not wear the talit in shul. Also, hishlich mishamayim eretz tiferet Yisrael, the pasuk symbolizing the idea of the beauty was thrown out, beauty representing the tefillin. So we do not wear the talit and tefillin in the morning shacharit in shul. We are going to wear them at home. We're going to say the Shema, and after doing so, we're going to come to shul and pray regular the tefillah of Tisha B'Av. In the afternoon, however, during Mincha, we are going to put on Talit and Tefillin. People who wear usually Rabbeinu Tam definitely should do so. Okay, so not an exception on Tisha B'Av. We should wear both Rashi and Rabbeinu Tam if you are usually doing so. But according to all opinions, we are going to have the Tefillin at least regardless for Mincha in the afternoon and remove them by Arvit. I wish you all an amazing day. Stay safe and cool.